cities are changing. It is 8:44. And so we're in the middle of a statement. Oh, and I put in what emergency.
Sorry.
Do you have any further questions?
No, that's safety is curious.
Okay, yes.
So for the safety, as well, you mentioned kids being able to run out and supervisions, whatnot. Only one classroom is going to be out on each structure at a time. Each classroom has three teachers. So the maximum would be the pre-K class, which has 24 students, has three teachers with it, which are the 4 to 5 year olds. And I understand that Shorewood has a very strong 4K program. We don't have that in Minneapolis, but your 4K program is a half day, so potentially you would have students for a half day. They would have three faculty members on site, which is, you know, 8 to 1 roughly, as well as the director would be around. You know, there's numerous people at the building that would be out there, but at a minimum there would be three. As the classes get younger, that ratio goes down. So for example, the 3 to 4 year old classroom is 3 faculty members for 20 students. The 2 to 3 year old classroom is 16 to 3. Under the age of 2 and a half, it's 12 to 3. So, I mean, there's substantial supervision as far as that is concerned.
Thank you. With no other further questions on safety, we'll just move to number 2, which is enjoyment of other existing property owners. Does anybody have any concerns or questions on that? Okay, or we'll move on to the condition of number 3, which is anybody have a concern or question on negative impact to the surrounding businesses? Commissioner Miller.
I'm not quite sure where the parking and the traffic flow come in, because those could impact the, you know, adjacent residences, as one of the neighbors spoke to.
Are you okay with us doing that?
I think that's number 5.
But I understand it could impact the other businesses.
Right, and just how the whole drug out pick up things.
So we'll get to that. Number 4 is, does anyone have any concern about adequate road access? I guess we could take that up with egress and access. So let's just get into ingress and exit, whatever that is. Number 5, traffic circulation. So I have some questions, but does anyone have any to start?
I can start with one. How do the deliveries arrive? We talked about farm truck deliveries. There's not really a spot when you take the alley out.
Yes, ma'am. So CASA supports local businesses, so already we've been in contact with your farmers market. We buy as much produce from local farmers as possible. When that is not available or in season, we go to co-ops. When the co-ops can't support, we could literally walk across the street to the metro and support their business as well. As far as the delivery trucks, they're no bigger than your typical UPS truck. They show up with food on Friday, and then they leave. They could park in front of the building or in the parking lot. We actually have a loading ramp on the wood side of the building in the northeast corner. So they could potentially pull in those 3 slots that we've created on the north side of the playground and be able to unload right there. We also have our own cargo van that would be delivering things for us that we would be able to minimize the amount of large trucks coming into the area.
You said the 3 and the northeast spot that would be created from this, aren't they parked by, isn't that already allocated for parked vehicles?
I'm sorry, ma'am?
The 3 spots that constitute a loading dock?
Yes, ma'am, and I'm using the historical, we're only going to have 8 staff members that drive. But if you're going to the letter of like, hey, you need to have this many parking spots, then yes, those would be parked, in which case they need to use street parking.
I'm sorry, but are you saying that you envision that these 3 spots would not be parked?
If historical data stands, which has been for the last 15 years in Minneapolis, then yes, ma'am, that I don't envision those spots necessarily being parked. If they are, there's other parking spots to the south of the building, but primarily I'd like to use that as the ingress and egress point.
And the cargo truck, you had other trucks that needed to be parked on site?
That would be a bus in a van, but they don't need to stay on site. I could bring them to somewhere else. It just depends on how the traffic flow with the city is and the parking flow is with the city as to whether those need to stay on site or not.
Not a parking question, but a vehicle question. So you have a van and a bus, you're going to pick up and drop off?
So in Minneapolis, we take each classroom on field trip every month. Our daughter's in the pre-K, so she usually goes on 2 to 3 field trips a month. We try and get them involved in the local community, the arts, that type of thing as much as possible. For example, the Seaquarium in Minneapolis, or the Sculpture Garden, or the History Museum. The kids are going there. They're 14-passenger vans. They're not, or 14-passenger buses. They're not the full-size bus. And that's what they're utilized for, is just to bring the kids on field trips. Again, with Shore having a strong public school system, and parents wanting their kids involved in that 4K program for at least a half a day, I could theoretically see us taking 2 elementary schools and dropping off in the future, but that's not something that we're looking to address right now for the simple fact of we truly don't know how that 4K model is going to affect our model. In Minneapolis, we have parents that ask if CASA can become an elementary school because they don't want their parents, they don't want their children to leave the Spanish school. But what I'm understanding with speaking to parents in the local community at Stone Creek, at Starbucks, and at Caribou, is how proud you guys are of your 4K program and how involved they want to be with that program. So I can absolutely see in the future, if we had the capacity for it, potentially, utilizing that bus to drop off our AM kids and pick up our PM kids at elementary schools, because no parent has time to leave their facility that they're at on their lunch break to go pick up their children, drive them to another daycare, eat lunch, and then drop them off. It's just a burden that we'd like to alleviate if possible. But again, that's something that we're not looking at 100% right now. Right now, we're going in with the idea that the kids will be in our center from drop off to pick up at 7:30 to 5:30 or 8:30 to 4:30, however the parents choose to set their schedule.
Trustee Amenta?
Can I just ask, I can tell you have a tremendous amount of passion for CASA Corazon, and if only my kids were still young enough, I would consider enrolling them. However, can you try to limit your answers to specifically the question, but just for sake of time, because we're already at 9 o'clock, and most of us are early to bed types, so I just ask if you could really just keep to the question. I would really appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Commissioner Miller?
I got from the memo that it doesn't appear likely that bus stop will move, or if it does, I really doubt we can move in front of Ruckus, because part of us granting them a parking exception was moving that bus stop from in front of their restaurant to where it is now. So I'm just wondering if you have a plan B and how you envision the whole parking, the drop-off working. Because at that age, kids are not going to unbuckle themselves from the car seat and run in to school. How long does it take? Do the parents do that in the parking lot as well as in Oakland? Or how much time do we anticipate?
So I have a 5-year-old and a 9-month-old. So I deal with a car seat and a 5-year-old every day, picking up and dropping off where Chelsea does. And it doesn't take more than 5-10 minutes at the most from parking your car, unbuckling it. Because generally parents will take the car seat as a whole. With the infant car seats, they can unbuckle them and carry them into the school. And then we have an area for car seat storage where the parents can then drop the car seat for the day. And then when they pick up their child, they can put them in the car seat and walk back to the street. Some parents do that sometimes.
Because I was just thinking, if 70 parents times however many minutes that is, it's, a lot of teachers doing handoff.
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
So, can I ask a clarifying question? We have not, Bart, can you just address, the bus stop does have an impact of whether it's going to be there or not. I have no recollection of that ruling of how that happens. Have you found anything?
I found no documentation that. So I guess, so when I talked to MCTS, they had indicated that village, and I don't know who that implies, if that was planning commission, village board, staff, however that was, when did the bus stop move, when the ruckus came through for their occupancy, and indicated that they were willing to move it, and the village agreed that it wouldn't be relocated in the future, because they also knew that the Golden Building had been, you know, was up for lease. In talking with Ogden, they were unaware of that agreement, so I don't know what that conversation was, and I had not found documentation of it. They just indicated to me when I reached out to them that they did not think moving would be likely, and they indicated that the village was okay with that at the time of the recent relocation. So that's what I indicated, and I still have no further documentation of it. If the planning commission remembers any further discussion of that at the time of the ruckus special exception, I'd be happy to hear or look into it, but from what I can find.
I can find my notes from that. Okay. So, but from your conversation, I guess that's the most important, is that it did not sound like it would be moved unless...
Correct. They indicated that they had thought that we had set up the matter, that we moved it, and then we moved on. Coming back a year or two later didn't seem open to them at this time.
And, okay, thank you very much. And to follow...
This is the only reason I brought that up, because with the amount of time for drop-offs or pickups, queuing of cars on Oakland or around the corner is the issue that for traffic flow that we really need to be concerned about, whether that's going to, you know, adversely affect the traffic flow in what's already a busy area.
And that's my clarification question for Bart. Can you just explain the change? Because when I asked the question, it was clarifying for me, and I think the other commissioners, the main entrance is moved. And
correct.
So if the bus stop stays, if someone was to drop off a child, and my assumption is more than likely they're not going to go here if they have to walk all the way down the street to get to the main entrance. So where would you, how does that egress and in and out, how does the in and out work? Along the alley parks, now that it's good, just explain.
I'll just start and then you let me know if that answers your question. So, yes, currently, or previously, the main entrance was located, you know, closer to Wells Fargo within the parking lot area where the apron spots are. My understanding is, based on the floor layout of the proposed use and the northeast section of the building has some, I don't know if it's a mezzanine or what it is, but there's some unusable space back there, so they'd like to put their utility functions there. So the proposed use had kind of flipped the main entrance to the corner of Wood and Oakland, as opposed to entering through the current, the entrance near the parking lot. So with that main entrance being flipped, obviously the parking is further away, so yes, people would have to park. You would walk up the sidewalk and open to the main entrance. With the bus stop not being removed, the main entrance kind of is further away from other access points. With the addition of the green space outdoor area, you know, currently cars could enter the parking lot and go north or south, exiting onto Wood or exiting onto Jarvis. With that, they're obviously only being allowed to go into Jarvis, so ingress and egress is being, you know, lessened from what it currently is. And I don't know if that answers the question.
One other point. So if you were going down Oakland and you're making a right.
You're going north on Oakland or you're going south on Oakland? No, okay.
So where can you park to drop off your child? Do you have to turn around?
You just have to park your car.
Right, so they're indicating that those five on-street parking spaces on Oakland within this block, those four within the green area, those would be created if the bus stop were to be removed, but like, as I indicated, the bus stop seems to not be an easy option at this point. So right now there's three on-street parking spaces on Oakland that you could pull into, and at that point, you know, you exit on the traffic like normal traffic patterns.
So if
you turn on the Wood Place, you would need to, turn to one of the driveways. They are creating that ingress egress on their lot to, you know, turn south into their property and then back out and possibly utilize those four or five spaces on the north side of the street. there's no way to control it. They have to turn to that parking lot, so that driveway, so, you know, other driveways possibly could be utilized for people to, you know, to make wide turns off of that, but they do have the one driveway that they could, you know, ideally utilize, but if those spots are utilized, someone's gonna have to go further east down the street to turn around.
So I think what I was trying to get at, too, that I was not aware of, was if you're going down, most likely you're gonna make north on Oakland, you're gonna make a right on Wood, and you're gonna wanna park, but you can't park on the south side of the street.
Correct.
So you have to turn around.
Correct.
And then, in order to turn around, I think concerns maybe that you're gonna be pulling into a lot of the private driveways to turn around to get to park so that you can make it into the main entrance. Is that?
Correct.
Okay.
Correct.
Okay. Does any, did you address that?
You're correct. So there was in the Goldie's building, the entrances are both on the north and the south. Those are both existing entrance points to that building. We have a plan. We've had a plan that has it to the south and to the north, so we would be open to entertaining if it's more advantageous to slide that entrance to the southwest corner. That does not affect the interior layout, causing this not to be feasible.